And all these components connect together. Of course, we have other factors, like environmental factors that would come into place. But in this case, we just want to face the reality and take data, put it into a population model, and say something about it. Oh, perfect. Thank you. I just thought my fingers have grown bigger and they can't press this. So, again, the data we extracted from the African billfish database, and mainly for shellfish. The way this data collected is on monthly basis. We have the date, weight, and location where the fish were caught. Captains reporting. And so we treated the yearly data to stand for our population data. And decided, because our monthly data sort of capture the changes in fishing dynamics, we treated that as our fishing data to calculate the fishing rate. Time is in season, because the way our fishing works, and I already explained that, is we have low fishing season and high fishing season. Low fishing season runs from May to July, and then we get into the high fishing season from October up to mid-March, or if things are going well weather-wise, end of March. So to get the fishing rate, we did some mathematical extrapolation, in this case using MATLAB, and we sort of wanted to capture the dynamics in this data. So we feeded the data, and one thing we noted that the seasonality of fishing changed with the number of fishermen that were going out there, and that helped us to capture the fishing rate. We represented our fishing rate as a degradation term, in this case, the number of shellfish that are caught on monthly basis. I don't want to go into the monthly part of it, but I want to run through what we did just to give you a picture before I make the final conclusion, because this presentation is not about methods. It's about what we try to do in order to come up with a conclusion for what can be done further. But in short, we use inverse problem to try and minimize the error between the model and the data we have. And decided to go really simple, because currently there's no time dynamic model that describes the behavior of shellfish population in the Indian Ocean. And so we chose the logistic model that has a rate of increase, and then we have things that are being taken out, in this time representing the fishing rate. The first thing was to feed the model, which was like feed the data onto the model. And I didn't want to show this, but it really gave us a bad feed, leaving out some data points. And you wouldn't want to show this to any person that wants to make inferences. We realized that there's something we are missing, and that's the changes that could be in the rate at which the shellfish are being taken out, which we explain that as the intrinsic growth, and also the changes in the seasonality of the fish capture, which is related to the fishing rate. So we decided to include that intrinsic rate to be time dependent, so that we are capturing the changes in time over the fishing year. It also included a carrying capacity that had a time dynamic factor. And as you can see from these two models, I would personally say they provided a better feed to the data we have. But one thing we also wanted to see was, would carrying capacity imply anything to this data? And of course, it still gave us a better feed. Looking at using a rate of increase that is time dependent, and also using a carrying capacity that is time varying as well. I asked my colleague, so should we just show this and end our conversation, end of story, you contributed to research? And we decided to run a couple of model test comparison to see which model best described what we were seeing in the data. And surely these runs provided us with the information that the model with an intrinsic rate of increase, that's showing that the capture of shellfish increased over time depending on the seasonality of capture, provided a better fit for the model with a constant carrying capacity. We threw out the other models, of course. I'm about to wrap it up. I said I'm gonna finish within the shortest time as possible. So, what does all this mathy stuff tell us? And this is something when I was talking to my favorite fishing guy on the Kenya coast, I was talking to him about what I was trying to do. He said, so I'm not really interested in the math. Well, what is this telling me? And it sort of struck me as somebody who's interested in both numbers and connecting numbers to the reality. I say, what this is explaining is that we have fish that is being taken out of the water in terms of the capture through angling or through artisanal fisheries. And this represents fishing rate. And so by showing this, it means that through the shellfish data, we can tell what's happening in the population. But one thing I have to note that this does not give a representation of the entire population, because we decided to use the billfish tagging data by just taking out the shellfish data. Finally, how does that imply to the whole management scenario? So if I can go to a fishery manager and say this is what taking out fish implies, then it's possible to look at sustainable fishing methods and look at other ways that we can work with artisanal fishermen, work with anglers to regulate the take of fish from the water. Finally, I'm gonna end with this pretty picture that doesn't say much, but just reminds me every time I talk about this work, and I know you can see I'm pretty calm about this. I'm not shaking because I've done this 2 times, but every time I look at this work, it reminds me of the intensity of how much has to be done to just come up with inferences. But by drawing one inference after the other, through this species that is highly migratory, those dots connect, the bigger dots connect to where the fish, the smaller dots is where the fish will start, the bigger dots connect to where the fish